فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الأصل الثاني معرفة دين الإسلام بالأدلة، وهو الاستسلام لله بالتوحيد والانقياد له بالطاعة والبراءة من الشرك وأهله، وهو ثلاث مراتب: الإسلام والإيمان والإحسان.
The author now رحمه الله تعالى, he finished the first asl. We finished the first asl. The first asl was what? معرفة العبد ربه. The slave knowing his Lord Allah. We finished that. We are now moving on to الأصل الثاني, the second asl, from the three fundamental principles, from the three things a person needs to know, and from the three things, this is the second one in which the author wrote the book for. And it is ma'rifatu, knowing deen al-islami bil adilla, knowing the religion of Islam with evidence. And the evidence needs to be known for each one. We already mentioned that. Ma'rifatullah, there has to be with evidence. Are you with me, brothers? Ma'rifatu deen al-islam is also with evidence. Also, ma'rifatu nabihi, knowing the Prophet ﷺ, is also with evidence. Each one, inshaAllah ta'ala. The word deen yutlaqu fi shar'i, in the sharia, the word deen is referred to as two things. In the sharia, the word deen has two meanings. One is ma'na, a meaning which is am, a comprehensive meaning. And it is ma anzalahu Allahu 'ala al-anbiya'i li tahqiq 'ibadatihi, is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he sent down on his messenger, on his prophets, to fulfill ubudiyah. So ubudiyah is established, servitude is established. So the generic and the general meaning of the word ad-deen is ma anzalahu Allah, anything Allah has sent down, ala al-anbiya'i, on the prophets. لتحقيق عبادته, to fulfill servitude, and for it to manifest on the face of this earth. The second one is التوحيد. The second one is خاص, specific, وهو التوحيد, it is توحيد. It's توحيد. Also the word Islam, the word Islam, in the Sharia, he has two usages. The first one is, the first usage of the word Islam is a generic and a general meaning. Itlaq, which is am, a general meaning. And it is al-istislamu lillahi bit-tawheed, submitting to Allah with tawheed. وَالْإِنْقِيَادُ لَهُ بِالطَّاعَةِ, and to also adhere to him in obedience. وَالْبَرَاءَةُ وَالْخُلُوصُ مِنَ الشِّرْكِ وَأَهْلِهِ, and also to free yourself from shirk and its people. If you summarize the Islam, the definition, or if you say الْإِسْتِسْلَامُ لِلَّهِ بِالتَّوْحِيدِ, that's enough. Really, if you just say al-istislamu lillahi bit-tawheed, it's actually correct. فَالْجُمْلَتَانِ اللَّتَانِ بَعْدَهُ, the two sentences after that, which is al-inqiyadu lahu bit-ta'a, which is to adhere to Allah in obedience, وَالْبَرَاءَةُ وَالْخُلُوصُ مِنَ الشِّرْكِ وَأَهْلِهِ, this is what it necessitates from al-istislamu lillahi. It's what comes out from that. And what's best in a definition is أن يكون جامعا مانعا. It should be comprehensive and it shouldn't allow other things to enter it. So this just استسلام لله بالتوحيد is enough. It'll get rid of the rest anyways. But if you expand on it more, no problem. There's a second meaning, which is خاص, specific. The second usage of the word Islam is, in the Sharia, is a specific usage. It's not general now. And the specific has two. The specific is two. A. الدين الذي بعث به به النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. The religion our messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم was sent with. And that is what the hadith refers to. بني الإسلام على خمس. الإسلام here means the religion that the Prophet was sent with. So it means that الاستسلام الباطن والظاهر لله تعبد لو بالشرع المنزل على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم على مقام المشاهدة أو المراقبة. It basically means to surrender to this religion of Islam externally and internally, worshipping Allah in accordance to how the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم came with it. The second one is B. Where does this fall under? The specific definition is al-amal al-zahira. The external acts are called Islam. This is where the opposite of it and iman comes. Are you with me? This is when it becomes all acts that are external are called Islam. As long as it's external, it's zahir. Al-a'mal al-zahira is called Islam. And the a'mal which are batina are called iman. But that's إذا اجتمع افترقا وإذا افترقا اجتمع. The Islam that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sent with has three levels. But the religion that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the deen that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sent with, are you with me, brothers? The deen that the Prophet ﷺ was sent with has three levels. The first one is martabatul a'mal al-zahira. The first level is the external acts. External acts. And that is called al-Islam. The second one is martabatul i'tiqadat al-batina. The internal acts. And that is al-Iman. The third station is called martabatu itqanihima, strengthening and perfecting the external and the internal, both of them. It's called al-Ihsan. And it is obligatory for every one of us to know a amount that is obligatory in Islam that we all have to know. Remember when we were talking about Allah, there is an amount that was obligatory for everybody to know, right? Also, there is a amount that is obligatory in all of those levels. Martabatul Islam, Martabatul Iman, and Martabatul Al-Ihsan. There is an amount that is obligatory for everybody to know. And those amount go back to three things. It goes back to three things. It goes back to three asal. Pay attention to this. وَالْوَاجِبُ مِنْهَا يَرْجِعُ إِلَىٰ ثَلَاثَةِ أُصُولٍ. The amount that's obligatory goes back to three foundations. The amount that is obligatory refers and it returns back to three foundations. So let's go back again. The martabatu al-Islam, martabatu al-Iman, and martabatu al-Ihsan. The author did not say you have to know these three. He says ma'rifatu deen al-Islami bil adillah. And then later he mentioned to you there were three. Al-Islam, wal-Iman, wal-Ihsan, right? The amount that's obligatory for you to know revolves around three things. It goes back to three things. It goes back to three foundations. فالأصل الأول, the first foundation is الاعتقاد, the belief. This is all three of them. All three of them, you have to know, you have to believe. كونه موافقا للحق في نفسه. That it is in accordance to the truth in which the Sharia came with. The second one is, and the first one is summarized in how, in what? In the six articles of faith. The six articles of faith. Al-Arkan al-Iman al-Sitta. The second one is what? Is al-fi'lu, the action. That movement, the qad amount that's wajib is what? Muwafaqatu harakati al-abdi, the person's actions. Muwafaqatu harakati al-abdi, the person's movements that he's coming with, and the actions which he is doing. Al-ikhtiyariya, that he has chosen. Batinan wa zahiran, externally and internally, it has to be in accordance to the Sharia. The actions of the slaves of two types. فِعْلُهُ مَعَ رَبِّهِ, actions with his Lord, Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala. And the second one is فِعْلُهُ مَعَ الْخَلْقِ, actions with the people. Are you with me? One is ibadat in fiqh, and one is mu'amalat in fiqh. The third asal that he goes back to is at-tarku, leaving off. والواجب فيه موافقة ترك العبد واجتنابه مرضاة الله. الترك leaving off. الواجب فيه موافقة ترك العبد. That the slave's leaving off is in accordance, and he staying off is all in accordance that which pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. والواجب فيه موافقة ترك العبد واجتنابه مرضاة الله. And this is, so the second one was what? Actions, right? Five pillars of Islam. The second one was five pillars of Islam. This third one, are you with me? This third one is what? It's called al-muharramat al-khams, the five muharramat that are agreed upon by all nations, all prophets. It's fawahish, ithm, baghi, al-shirk, and al-qawlu ala Allah bighayri ilm. The first one is fahisha. Fahisha, when it comes, it means zina. Second one is al-ithm. الإثم, which is sins, major sins. والبغي, transgression. Which is innovation. والشرك, which is shirk. Last but not least, وَالْقَوْلُ عَلَى اللَّهِ بِغَيْرِ عِلْمٍ, speaking about Allah with no knowledge. All of those three is the amount that every single body has to know in the religion of Al-Islam. The six articles of faith, the five pillars of Al-Islam, and the five al-muharramat al-khams. All five of those. Ibn al-Qayyim brings them all in his kitab, Miftahu Dar al-Sa'adah. It's all taken from the book, Miftahu Dar al-Sa'adah, written by who? Ibn al-Qayyim al-Jawziyyah. Naam.
كل مرتبة لها أركان. أركان الإسلام خمسة: شهادة أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمدا رسول الله، وإقام الصلاة وإيتاء الزكاة وصوم رمضان وحج بيت الله الحرام. فدليل الشهادة قوله تعالى: شهد الله أنه لا إله إلا هو والملائكة وأولو العلم قائما بالقسط. ألا لا إله إلا هو العزيز الحكيم، ومعناها لا معبود بحق إلا الله، لا إله نافيا جميع ما يعبد من دون الله إلا الله، مثبتا العبادة لله وحده لا شريك له في عبادته، كما أنه ليس له شريك في ملكه. وتفسيرها الذي يوضحها قوله تعالى: وإذ قال إبراهيم لأبيه وقومه إنني براء مما تعبدون إلا الذي فطرني. وقوله تعالى: قل يا أهل الكتاب تعالوا إلى كلمة سواء بيننا وبينكم ألا نعبد إلا الله ولا نشرك به شيئا ولا يتخذ بعضنا بعضا أربابا من دون الله، فإن تولوا فقولوا اشهدوا بأننا مسلمون. ودليل شهادة أن محمدا رسول الله قوله تعالى: لقد جاءكم رسول من أنفسكم عزيز عليه ما عنتم حريص عليكم بالمؤمنين رؤوف رحيم. ومعنى شهادة أن محمد رسول الله طاعته فيما أمر، وتصديقه فيما أخبر، واجتناب ما عنه نهى وزجر، وأن لا يعبد الله إلا بما شرع. ودليل الصلاة والزكاة وتفسير التوحيد قوله تعالى: وما أمروا إلا ليعبدوا الله مخلصين له الدين حنفاء ويقيموا الصلاة ويؤتوا الزكاة وذلك دين قيما. ودليل الصيام قوله تعالى: يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون. ودليل الحج قوله تعالى: ولله على الناس حج البيت من استطاع إليه سبيلا ومن كفر فإن الله غني عن العالمين. المرتبة الثانية: الإيمان.
لا إن شاء الله صلى. After the author rahimahullah clarified maratibuddin al-thalath, when he clarified that the religion is categorized, it is placed in three levels, he now went on to saying that kullu martabatin laha arkan, each level has a pillar. And he started with al-islam. Islam has five pillars, my beloved brothers and sisters, and it is all mentioned in one hadith, hadith Abdullah ibn Umar ibn al-Khattab رضي الله تعالى عنهما, which is in Sahih al-Bukhari and Muslim, which the author brought. Then the author rahimahullah, after telling us the reality of what religion of Islam is and its levels and its pillars, he brought the evidence and said, وَالدَّلِيلُ قَوْلُهُ تَعَالَى, the evidence for it is إِنَّ الدِّينَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ الْإِسْلَامِ, the religion that Allah will accept is Islam. What does that mean, that the religion that Allah will accept is Islam? أي الدليل على أن الدين الذي يجب اتباعه هو دين الإسلام. إن الدين عند الله الإسلام means what? The religion that is obligatory to be followed. الدين الذي يجب اتباعه, the religion that it's obligatory to follow it, هو دين الإسلام. It is the religion of Islam. That's what it means, the ayah. Then the author also brought the statement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَمَنْ يَبْتَغِ غَيْرَ الْإِسْلَامِ دِينًا, anyone who tries to seek other than Islam as a religion, فَلَنْ يُقْبَلَ مِنْهُ, it will not be accepted from him. وَهُوَ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ, and on the day of judgment, he's going to be from the destroyed ones. Both of those ayat are talking about the Islam which is am or Islam which is khas? Right, let's apply what we learned. This ayat right now, which one does it fall under? Yeah? Is it khas, eh? Who else? One says khas, you take khas, I'll take general. Yeah? Okay, how is it general? How is it khas? The one who said general has to answer, the one who said specific has to answer. Na'am. So the ayah that said, Inna deena indallahi al-Islam. The Islam here is the general Islam. The one that we said, following what? Khitab al-Shara. Following the addressing of the Sharia. Following what? The addressing of the Sharia. And how the Sharia addressed. So it's the general use. وَالْآيَتَانِ تَتَعَلَّقَانِ بِالْإِسْلَامِ بِمَعْنَاهُ الْعَامِ. The first of them is from the five pillars of Islam is what? شَهَادَةُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ وَأَنَّ مُحَمَّدًا Rasulullah. So how many shahada are there? Two shahada. It's called shahadataini. That's what's called shahadataini. Taini means two. First shahada is what? A shahada to be tawheed, right? Are you with me, brothers? The second shahada is what? Bir risala. I'm going to ask you guys this question. The first one, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, is shahada of tawheed. A shahada to be tawheed. وَشَهَدُ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ is what? الشَّهَادَةُ بِالرِّسَالَةِ. What's the evidence for شَهَادَةُ أَنَّ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ? The author brought قَوْلُهُ تَعَالَى شَهِدَ اللَّهُ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ. Surah Al Imran. What did he bring for وَشَهَدُ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ? لَقَدْ جَاءَكُمْ رَسُولٌ مِنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ. That is for وَأَشَهَدُ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدًا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ. You have to understand the way the author is trying to use the evidences, or else you're going to be a person who's memorizing a dalil and does not even know how to extract the evidence from it. What does it mean عَزِيزٌ عَلَيْهِ مَا عَنِدْتُمْ? مَا مَعَنَى عَنِدْتُمْ? The word عَنِدْتُمْ means الْمَشَقَّةِ. عَنَتْ in the Arabic language, it means مَشَقَّةِ, hardship. He is one is the Prophet ﷺ was one honorable and caring for us in that which is hard on us. He wants to make it easy for us, alayhi salatu wasalam. Azizun alayhi ma anitum. The second pillar is what? As-salah. It's as-salah. Salah is a rukun. It's a pillar min arkan al-Islam. And it is the praying of what? Salatul yawmi wal layla. You pray day and night. How many salahs do you pray daytime? Two. Sah? Or three? One we pray in daytime. Sah? Brothers, be awake. Three is where we pray daytime. And two we pray at nighttime. The third pillar is what? Az-zakat. Zakat is what? Hiya ruknu min arkani al-Islam. It's a pillar from the pillars of al-Islam. What does it mean? It means az-zakat al-mafruḍah al-mu'ayyanah bil-amwal. This zakat here doesn't mean any other zakat. It means the zakat that is connected to your wealth. Zakat al-fitr doesn't enter this. This is not a dalil for zakat al-fitr. Zakat al-Fitr, is it wajib? It's wajib. But it's not min jumlati zakati allati hiya ruknu min arkan al-Islam. But it's not this one that the rukn, the pillar of Islam is connected to. No. What's the evidence for the salah and the zakat? The author wrote, وَمَا أُمِرُوا إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ. Establishing the religion. The author brought this ayah for it. What does it mean? وَذَلِكَ دِينُ الْقَيِّمَةِ. What does it mean? وَذَلِكَ دِينُ الْقَيِّمَةِ. Huh? Now what does it, دِينُ الْقَيِّمَةِ, what does قَيِّمَةِ mean? Specifically the word. The upright religion. It is, هِيَ الْمُسْتَقِيمَةُ الْمُنَزَّلَةُ عَلَى الْأَنْبِيَاءِ وَهُوَ دِينُ الْإِسْلَامِ. هِيَ الْمُسْتَقِيمَةُ, it is the one that's upright, straight, steadfast. الْمُنَزَّلَةُ عَلَى الْأَنْبِيَاءِ, that are sent upon the messengers. The fourth pillar is what? الصوم, fasting. Fasting is a pillar from the pillars of what? رُكْنٌ مِنْ أَرْكَانِ الْإِسْلَامِ. And the fasting here is صوم رمضان, the fasting of Ramadan, في كل سنة, the whole year. And the evidence that the author brought is what? يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, those of you who believe, كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ, fasting has been made obligatory on you. كَمَا كُتِبَ, as it has been made obligatory on what? عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ, those who came before you. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ, so you can attain what? التقوى. Why were you created for? عبادة. Why do you come with عبادة? تقوى. Is that understood? Why were you created for? عبادة. Why do you come with عبادة? To attain تقوى. لعلكم تتقون. تقوى is what you attain from your ibadah. وَالرُّكْنُ الْخَامِسُ, the fifth pillar is what? الْحَجُّ, حَجْ. وَهُوَ رُكْنُ مِنْ أَرْكَانِ الْإِسْلَامِ, and it is a pillar from the pillars of Islam. حَجُّ الْفَرْضِ إِلَى بَيْتِ اللَّهِ الْحَرَامِ, it is obligatory to what? Go to do Hajj. Is Umrah in here? Naam. Umrah is a pillar. It's Hajj, you have to come with it. Bi asahhi, according to the strongest opinion of the scholars. What's the evidence for that? وَلِلَّهِ عَلَى النَّاسِ حُجُّ الْبَيْتِ مَنِ اسْتَطَاعَ إِلَيْهِ سَبِيلًا. وَلِلَّهِ, upon Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He has over the sleep. People is what? حُجُّ الْبَيْتِ, had Hajj to the Kaaba. Then the author, rahimahullah, he stuck to clarifying حَقِيقَةُ الرُّكْنَيْنِ الْأَوَّلَيْنِ. The Shaykh only sufficed himself with clarifying the first two pillars. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمد رسول الله. Why did he do that? لِشِدَّةِ الْحَاجَّةِ إِلَيْهِمَا. The need is for them is the greatest. And وَكَثْرَةِ الْمُخَالِفِ فِيهَا. The people who are opposing us on this is the biggest one. So he clarified what لا إله إلا الله is. And he mentioned that La ilaha illallah, brothers, is what? Jami'un bayna al-nafi wal-ithbat. Jami'un bayna al-nafi wal-ithbat. It encompasses, it brings together two things. Affirmation and negation. Negation of what? Jami'un ma yu'badu min duni Allah. Negating everything that is worship besides Allah. And affirmation of what? العبادة لله وحدة, that Allah is the only one who deserves to be worshipped. And the author, he brought evidences for the ithbat, the affirmation, and he brought evidence for the nafi. What was the evidence that he brought for the nafi? وَإِذْ قَالَ إِبْرَاهِيمُ لِأَبِيهِ وَقَوْمِهِ إِنَّنِي بَرَاءٌ مِمَّا تَعْبُدُونَ. This is the nafi. I am free. I have nothing to do. Free in myself. I am negating everything that you guys worship besides Allah. That's the evidence for what? The nafi, the negation. And where did he bring the evidence for the isbat? إِلَّا الَّذِي فَطَرَنِي. إِلَّا الَّذِي فَطَرَنِي except the one who what? The one who provides for me, sustains me, created me, is the one I only worship. This is the affirmation. And both of them can be found in قوله تعالى قُلْ يَا أَهْلَ الْكِتَابِ تَعَالَوْا إِلَىٰ كَلِمَةٍ سَوَاءٍ بَيْنَنَا وَبَيْنَكُمْ أَلَّا نَعْبُدَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ That we don't worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala إِلَىٰ آخِرِ الْآيَةِ Then the author went on to explaining وَأَشَدُ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ What did he define وَأَشَدُ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ What did he define? That أَشَدُ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ means He says, طَاعَتُ فِي مَا أَمَرْ أَشْهَدُ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ If somebody asks you today, I ask you now, مَا مَعَنَا لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ لَا مَعْبُودَ بِحَقٍ إِلَّا اللَّهِ مَا مَعَنَا أَشْهَدُ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ This, for me, صراحةً, the statement right now has in my mind something. Recently, my kids, my son, Ibrahim, came up to me. So he had an exam. He's in Egypt. So he came up to me. It really touched me, this. He said to me, Abi, Dad, ما معنى أشهد أن محمد رسول الله I learned in school today. So he's testing me. So I said to him, what is it? And he said to me, طاعته فيما أمر واجتنابه فيما نهى عنه وزجر وَتَصْدِيقُوا فِي مَا أَخْبَرُ وَأَلَّا يُعْبَدَ اللَّهِ إِلَّا بِمَا شَرَعَ Hearing it from a four-year-old saying that and memorizing that, knowing it, what it means is better, it felt better for me خَيْرٌ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا وَمَا فِيهَا If I was give everything on this earth and in it, that's enough. That's worth living for. That your child knows مَعْنَى لَا إِلَهِ إِلَّا اللَّهِ Not in English, in Arabic, he's saying in Arabic. La ilaha illallah and Muhammad al-Rasulullah. Which is ta'atu many people who've been Muslims 40 to 50 years don't know that. Which is what? Ta'atu fi ma'amar. Ma'ana shad Muhammad al-Rasulullah means, Ya ikhwa, if you don't know what something means, you're not going to come with it. Are you going to come with it? So many people are saying, I testify Muhammad is the messenger of Allah. You look at him, he's got nothing to do with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So now you can't say your difference is very light. No, our difference is not light. Our difference is what Ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah. We're actually debating and arguing about what Ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah. Let's look at what Muhammad Rasulullah means. Ya ikhwan, who wrote this book? Muhammad ibn AbdulWahhab. He wrote this book, right? Is this book considered one of the smallest books to study, to start with? It is, right? Is it a complicated, sophisticated book? I'm asking you guys a question. It's from the smallest aqidah books, tawheed books that you study. Look at each point what he carries. Ta'atu fi ma amar. You obey the messenger in that which he commanded you. Number one. Wa tasdiqu fi ma akhbar. Every single thing he told you about, you believe it. Wa ijtinabu fi ma naha anhu wa zajar. You stay away from everything he prohibited you from. Wa alla yu'bad Allah illa bima shara'a. And you worship Allah based on that which he legislated, Nabi Allah Muhammad. Those four knots, those four points are what it is. So those five points, ta'atu fi ma amar, wa tasdiqu fi ma akhbar, wa ijtinabu ma na'an wa zajar, wa alla yu'bad Allah illa bima shara. It's four, right? It's four. Those are the four that it means wa ashhadu anna Muhammad al-Rasulullah. If you cut your beard, there's a khalal, a deficiency in your ashhadu anna Muhammad al-Rasulullah. Deficiency. There's a weakness here. Because what was the first thing? طَاعَتُ فِي مَا أَمَرْ Obeying him in that which he commanded you. He's the one who commanded you to let your beard grow. Are you with me, brothers? The matter, you have to realize where it stems to, is how serious and dangerous it can get. Are you with me, brothers? Innovation, which is وَأَلَّا يُعْبَدَ اللَّهِ إِلَّا بِمَا شَرَعَ That you worship Allah based on what legislation? You see why the scholars, they say, bid'ah is what? شَرَكُ الشِّرْكِ We took it the other day, right? Ta'zim al-ilmi. That innovation is the net that brings in shirk. How does it bring it in? You're going to go against shahada anna Muhammad Rasulullah. Later you're going to fall into against la ilaha illallah. You're going to be fighting. You're leaving Islam because of that. Are you with me, brothers? وَتَصْدِيقُوا فِي مَا أَخْبَرُ. Everything that the Prophet told us, brothers, we believe in it. Unwavering conviction. If the Prophet tells you something, what do you do? For you believe in it. You don't question him. Did the messenger say it? Khalas. Don't ask more. You take it. You obey everything which he commanded you, alayhi salatu wasalam. And you stay away from everything he told you to stay away from. Because you know if he prohibited you from something and told you to stay away from something, it means what? There's a harm in it for you. Stay away from it. We never listened. We did what the Prophet, we fell into the sins that the Prophet prohibited us from. What happened, brothers? I'm asking a simple question. We heard of illnesses that we never heard of before. Huh? HIV, AIDS. I'm saying AIDS because Somalis say it like that. It's AIDS. And HIV. And things like that, we've heard of them. Amrad. All we could have done from the get-go is to stay away from zina. All of these illnesses, everything, brothers, that you go against the Prophet's command, you are going to taste the bitterness of your consequences. It's happened. It's going to happen. Are you with me, brothers? Then the author, rahimahullah, after he mentions that, نعم تفضل. He mentions.